worship by singing the Tri-Services version of the Nathan hymn, Eternal Father, Strong to Save.
Let us pray for all who suffer as a result of conflict and ask that God may give us peace. For servicemen and women who have died in the violence of war, each one remembered by and known to God. For those who love them in death as in life, offering the distress of our grief and the sadness of our loss. For all members of the armed forces who are in danger this day, remembering family, friends, and all who pray for their safe return. For civilian women, children, and men whose lives are disfigured by war or terror, calling to mind in penitence the anger and hatreds of humanity. For peacemakers and peacekeepers, who seek to keep this world secure and free. For all who bear the burden and privilege of leadership, asking for gifts of wisdom and resolve in the search for reconciliation and peace. All our prayers we bring together in the words which Jesus taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
reading from the Gospel according to St. Matthew, chapter 5. Jesus saw the crowds. He went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." This is the word of the Lord.
We stand to sing the hymn, "Jerusalem."
Unique possessions, quick hand and practiced eye, the senses and action stations alert to perceive or die. Gun proud and proud of body, with stripped and easy mind, oh death, be kind to the squally, in whom our world shall find its seed and fierce begetting, the future and shining. sprung from our dark sun setting, our harvest, bird in hand.
Here inscribed the names of friends we knew, young men with whom we often flew. Scrambled to many angels high, they knew that they or friends might die. Many were very scarcely trained, and many badly burnt or maimed. Behind each name a story lies of bravery in some skies. The many brave unwritten tales were simply told in vapor trail. Many now lie in sacred graves, and many rest beneath the wave. Outnumbered every day they flew, remembered here as just the few.
Oh, I have slipped the surly bonds of earth, and danced the skies on laughter-silvered wings. Sunward I have climbed, and joined the tumbling mirth of sun-split clouds, and done a hundred things you have not dreamed of. Wheeled and soared and swung high in the sunlit silence. Hovering there, I chased the shouting wind along and flung my eager craft through footless halls of air. Up, up the long, delirious, burning blue, I topped the windswept heights with easy grace whenever lark or even eagle flew. And while with silent, lifting mind I've trod the high, untrespassed sanctity of space, put out my hand and touched the face of God.
Oh, very low-key announcement from General Eisenhower's headquarters told the world the long-awaited invasion of Europe had commenced along the coast of Normandy. Allied naval forces, supported by strong air forces, began landing Allied armies this morning on the northern coast of France, said the statement. No place names were given. In fact, nothing that would help the enemy. But the operation was to be decisive in bringing the war to a conclusion.
They tell me he always fought bravely. They say what a hero was he. They tell me he'd do whatsoever was asked if it meant they could gain victory. They tell me, though wounded, he always fought on and always supported his men. It was only when fighting had finally ceased would he call for some help. Not till then. I stood on the tarmac and awaited the plane that would bring my dear loved one back home. Then it came into view with the metal so bright and that unmistakable drone. They tell me at times, I suppose just like this, that each yard can seem like a mile. But in just a few minutes, he was back in my arms with that unmistakable smile. He may have been special to many, and no one could e'er disagree. But as I held him that day in a field far away, he was the most special to me.
We sing the hymn, Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven. Please sit for our final reading. Remember Yeats, Gallipoli, the song, Mourns, Verdun. Remember the Western Desert, El Alamein, the Northern Beaches. Remember Coventry, Dresden, Hiroshima,
and the Burma Road. Remember Korea, the Falklands, Northern Ireland, the Balkans, East Timor, Afghanistan, and the Gulf. Remember the courage, the comradeship, the ingenuity, the spirit of working together for a common cause, the planning together for a better world that would come with peace. Remember the call to arms, the patriotic songs, the partings which were such sweet sorrows, the sound of the drums, the skill of the pipes, the prayer that God would be on our side. Remember the carnage, the colossal horrors of war. Remember the widows, 60 years and more. The old men and women who never knew their fathers. Remember the love that was lost, the wisdom wasted, the minds that were still pain by memories. Remember the families bereaved by recent wars and conflict. Remember this day, the children who died while nations fight nations. Remember one who asked us to remember them. God remembered us and forgive us for our sins against you and humanity.
We stand for the national anthem.
Standards.
May God grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the Church, the Queen, the Commonwealth, and all people, peace and concord, and to us and all his servants, life everlasting, and the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, come down upon you and remain with you always. Amen.